I've got demo discs, a whole bunch of them. When I was young, my mother wanted me to read, so she got me a subscription to the official PlayStation magazine because I would not read anything else except video game related stuff. And then that continued. Well, actually, she did that for Nintendo Power when I was a young man. And then that continued into the Sega Genesis magazine, which I forget what it was called. And then eventually the official PlayStation magazine, just kind of like a birthday gift every year, was a subscription. And they had demo discs, so, and I've kept on all this time. So dating back to October 1999, I have the PlayStation demo disc for PS1, and then another one for PS1. And then I also, for whatever reason, kept the demo disc that came with my PlayStation 1 when I bought it. But I have since kept a plethora of PlayStation 2 demo discs, starting with issue 53 and ending with issue 112. Now, I don't have all of those demo discs, but I have a good number of them. So I am going to record just me playing through them and see how this stuff holds up 20 years later. Hey gang, back with another PlayStation, official PlayStation magazine demo disc. We have issue number 59 with Britney Spears on the cover. We got a rhythm game, a fun rhythm game. It's going to be Britney Spears. I think Oops, I Did It Again is the song. And I think I remember that because I feel like I did a... I did an oral presentation in French class when I was in college about the benefits of video games and music. But like,
welcome to issue,
yeah, let's watch this intro.
PlayStation Underground. In this issue, we get a glimpse at the new SEA.com website and find out what goes into bringing you the coolest new community for gamers on the web. Fans of TV's The King of Queens get to hang out with celebrity gamer Patton Oswalt as he shares his deep, dark fitness confessions. We've also got ringside seats as we go behind the scenes with the developers at Crave Entertainment to find out what goes into making a champion for their new title.
Oh man, those guys are dead.
They jump right into the ring with their demo in the vault, along with others like Freakstyle and Stuntman. You got all this, plus cool moves, downloads, and more.
So they killed that. They killed that. They got rid of the girl from the previous one. She's gone. That CG character who didn't clean her room. Okay, and here's a little thing. What was I talking about? Oh yeah, I did a presentation in college in French class, and it was like, I don't know, the guy was a music teacher, so he kind of forced us all to talk about music, so I just did music and video games, and I showed an example of Guitar Hero, I showed an example of the Britney Spears game. Alright, so we're on a submarine. Behind the scenes. Download station. All right, this is always interesting. Let's see what they got for us. Whew, okay. Take me, man, the loading to get to the download station. High Heat Baseball. Press the square button for info about this download. Updated player rosters. That's good. And boost new schedule and updated player rosters. Okay, so it's just new season. All right, splashdown. All characters, all vehicles unlocked. Okay, those are your two downloads. Cool. Oh man, I'm not a fan of this UI. Slow UI, taking me around. Okay, download station. Bulletins. Okay, I can skip it. Threads, promo calendar, credits, fine print. Okay, threads, bulletin. Oh, a DVD case, $11.99. I think I got that for free because I had registered my PS2, my second PS2 that I bought because I bought a Slim, my PSP, my second PSP, my third PSP because I bought the PSP Go. So like, I registered all these things, and then Sony's like, hey man, you seem to be a fan. Do you want to be like part of our exclusive club? And they would send me like little demos for PSP. And they also sent me like that DVD case slash agenda. I had an agenda. It wasn't just DVDs. cool. Promo calendar. PlayStation 2 has a busy summer. Oh, there's more. Roaming around the country with the Vans Warped Tour. If you haven't been able to catch the show, don't worry, it's not over yet. Check out warpedtour.com for final dates and locations to get some great music to go along with your gaming action. Ozfest, okay, is bringing you the biggest rock fest of the year. Come along as we present Ozfest, a one-of-a-kind experience. 32 shows will span the country, combining some of the hottest names in rock with the coolest gaming around. Check out ozfest.com for exact dates and locations. Come for the music, stay for the games. Okay. All right. Credits and fine print, we don't really care about. Okay. Cool moves. Celebrity gamer, the vault behind the scenes. All right. I guess we'll do cool moves first. Getting around the Borgnine cab in Grand Theft Auto 3.
My name is DeMarlo King. I'm here to show you a cool move for Grand Theft Auto 3. In this cool move, I'm going to show you how to get the red cab after you get the 100th passenger drop off. Now, if you notice on my stat screen, I already have 99 passenger drop offs. Now, I already have my 100th passenger drop off in the car right now, which I'm about to attempt to drop off and then go pick up our new ride.
So, already. With Grand Theft Auto 3, they were already making you do so much dumb bullshit unrelated to the game.
Giving you a message saying that you have your new cab waiting at the Borgnine taxi place. Let's head over there right now. Should be waiting for us.
So his cool move is drop off 100 people. He didn't teach us anything. There was no, like, how to do things. He was just like, drop off 100 people.
Take any means necessary to get over there.
This isn't a cool move. I'm not impressed. But, hey, you get a new cab.
There she is. She's a beaut. Let's get in. And there you have it. Now, with the new cab we just got, it's faster, it's better handling than most of the other cars in the game, and it looks pretty cool. So now, it's all on you.
Man, not a cool move. Oh, well. I guess they can't be all like that. Shadow of the Colossus one. Maximo, finding extra goodies. Okay. Man, Maximo, that was like the
My name is Saul Viega.
Ghost and Goblins knockoff?
Cool game, Maximo. In this cool move, I'm going to show you how to get some hidden keys and some treasure. From the beginning, work your way through this swampy area. And head on past these crypts right here. What you're looking for is a large tree stump. You can actually double jump up this little mushroom ledge right here, which will get you on top of the tree stump. Now from the tree stump, you can actually jump over the crypt right next to you. And you can also get to this elevated path right here.
What a...
And you want to follow it all the way to the end.
Okay, here we go. Actual hidden content. Don't fall off the edge, Saul. Okay, good job.
And at the end, you can grab a key. Don't jump off just yet. What you want to do is head back to the crypt that you just came from. There's still more treasure and keys to get.
And I don't know how hidden this is either. I feel like people just would have done this through regular exploration.
Here you can double jump to the other crypt. And you can grab some treasure here.
Okay then, hold on.
And you can grab another key. Now that you've gotten these keys, you can get the treasure below and open up the locks to the crypts. Make sure to be careful when you're jumping from crypt to crypt.
I feel like I know Saul from somewhere.
It's really easy to fall off. But once you get those keys, you'll be able to...
Well, maybe not. Maybe I just seen him in a different video. A lot easier for you. All right, thanks, Saul, for that cool loot video. I guess, in Maximo. Draken the Ancient Gates. The Bitter Touch Sword. Alright. This has gotta be an actual hidden item. I'm a believer.
I'm Anthony Bell, and I work for Sony QA, and I'm going to be showing you a cool move on Drakan the Ancient's Gates. This is going to be retrieving the Bitter Touch. The way that you start to retrieve the Bitter Touch is leave Serdana Town Square by crossing the bridge towards Shadowmire. Shadowmire will be on the left-hand side. You'll see the sign here. You want to stay to the right of that and travel down this rock outcropping down this hill. And over on the right-hand side, you see a house. You'll need to go past that and around the back side. And you'll need to talk to one of the villagers who will send you on a quest to get his wife.
I still feel like this isn't a hidden thing.
Which is on my left-hand side. Go past the trees and the rocks. And
although I don't even know what this game is.
To this house. There'll be a farmer standing there plowing. And you talk to him and he'll give you the quest to go after his wife. And that's where you'll find the Bitter Touch.
Please, miss.
Looks like one of the early early Western RPGs where they
weapon to pick up early on in the game is it does 8 points of damage, it's armor
inspired, you know,
freeze your enemy, allowing you to shatter them into a million pieces.
Like what's it called? I don't remember what they're called. The Fusoya guy, Fusroda, whatever the fuck it is.
Going in to retrieve it. Don't worry about too many things following
you.
Yeah,
it's not important. I don't play those games.
The hill here to the right.
Whew. Caught on that mushroom.
Careful not to fall off.
Don't fall off, even though that's exactly where you're going. I wonder if you die if you fall off. I like how it has like the
mushrooms, and behind that is the Bitter Touch sword.
Why'd you have to get the quest?
One button to retrieve it. It'll fly into your hand. And then go into your inventory and select it with the square button. So there you have it, the Bitter Touch sword. As you proceed through the game, by picking up these weapons that only require one melee skill point to use, you'll be able to work on other attributes such as magic and archery that will better benefit you in sticky situations while still maintaining a good melee or having good melee weapons. So get out there, open up those gates, and have fun.
I guess it was hidden. Why did we have to go get that quest? Anyway. Max Payne, Rats with Guns. All right, this is an actual Easter egg, sounds like.
Hi, I'm Manuel, and today I'm going to show you a cool move for Max Payne. This cool move is basically going to show you how to shoot it out with some of the rats you'll find down at the lower levels. This cool move takes place in Part 1, The American Dream, Chapter 2, One Way or the Other. Before you start, you're probably going to want to use the All Weapons cheat. To do that, pause the game and enter L1, L2, R1, R2, Triangle, Square, X, and Circle.
Thanks for the cheat, I guess.
Go to your weapons and equip the grenades. Walk up to this hole here and toss a grenade in there. Stand back so you don't get hurt by the blast. Now at this point, there's no real indication that the Easter egg has been enabled, so you're just going to have to go to the end of the level. Go through here, you're going to want to take out these two guys. Go through this door. Come down here and take out that guy. Hit this guy right here.
As he clips through the wall.
And just continue down through here. And right now, you, if you need it, you might want to reload your weapon or use any painkillers if you need them. Just continue running through here and come up to a platform here.
Man, they really should have used some editing and just like, we're going to fast forward to the end of the level.
Jump up on the platform. Take out this other guy here. And again, reload your weapon or use any painkillers if you need them.
Thanks for the tip on using the painkillers.
Top of these stairs here, you'll notice all the rats on the ground. You're not going to do anything at first, but now you notice they all have guns. And eventually, they'll start shooting unless I take the first shot. So, the rats are basically just going to try to kill you. So you're going to want to get them first. Probably going to need some painkillers here so you don't die.
That's definitely an old school Easter egg. Serve no purpose.
And I believe all the rats are dead. So there you go. You know, there's no real advantage for doing this cool move. It's just fun to see the rats with the guns and try to kill them before they kill you. So now you know how to do it. Go have some fun.
Should have given me more cheats. Give me just the infinite weapon cheat or all weapon cheat. Okay, and that was all of them. Okay. I guess we'll go to the Celebrity Gamer. Yeah, we'll go to the Celebrity Gamer, which is Patton Oswalt.
This is where I make money to buy drugs.
Man, remember when he was funny?
So, yeah, I play this character named Spence on the show King of Queens.
He's yeah, look how young he is.
Wacky side guys.
That's our director, and I don't want to bother them. Let's watch them work for a second.
So if you don't fight the bucket will be your friend. Do you understand?
Yeah, so then that's basically what we have.
Is he a gamer?
This is my first PlayStation 2. Any of my friends are watching this. I'm sorry I haven't called, but it's because I've been in here playing PlayStation and eating Cheetos.
Yeah.
You know, my friends all have them. When I go over to their houses, and I'll spend hours, man. And I'm at their house. Like, I'm supposed to be visiting and being social, and I'm just sitting there like an idiot playing Grand Theft Auto 3.
Games get in the way of work.
You know, I first started getting into them. Playing them on my computer.
Man, look at all those comic writing, books.
Which was a bad, really bad idea. So now in my mind, I'm thinking, okay, I'll just get a separate system, put it on my TV, and I'll parcel it out. Like, I'll play for now and then go, okay, I gotta get work done. And then I'll do 5 minutes of work and then another hour.
Hey, can we get some shots of you playing Gran Turismo? Sure.
8 a.m. tomorrow?
What a weird.
No. Perfect.
You got the day off.
This time, make sure that they simonize, okay?
Got it.
the oldest joke in the book.
Hey, fatty, stop fooling yourself. Get a PS2, all right? You're not going to excel at sports. Women don't like you. Get it? It'll be your only friend. I've made the Switch. Why don't you?
Roll Man, he's talking straight to me.
People like us shouldn't be outside, because we just get hurt. That'd be my ad. I'm serious, man. Why the hell are people going outside?
We went mountain biking today.
Really? I've got that on CD-ROM. I already did that. And I ate cereal while I did it, genius. So why don't you and Grizzly Adams go climb a mountain or something and wrestle an eagle? I'm gonna.
Man, look at this early 2000s attitude of hating healthy people.
Get a shot of the treadmill that I don't use. Get a shot of the treadmill. Ha ha! I don't use that. I just have it there to impress the chicks. And I hang my nunchucks from it. I hang my nunchucks off my treadmill. How symbolic is that? How pathetic. Whatever.
Man, are the Celebrity Gamers all just like B-level comedians of the time? Wayne Brady, now Patton Oswalt. All right. Cool, I guess. Behind the scenes, what do you got for me? Last time, this was like so many videos and they were so long. Virtua Fighter 4. The results are unbelievable. Get behind the scenes with Crave's latest edition of UFC, which of course EA makes now. Do you have a good idea what goes into making video games? See what goes into making a video game website. All right, probably not interesting at all. All right, let's go. Virtua Fighter 4. What is this graphic? Oh, it's a board, which is ironic. Oh, I guess it was the board inside the. The PlayStation 2 controller
in your hand, you only speak in half sentences. For a second, I forget about the game on the screen, worry about if the controller will hold up under this pounding. I've got a front row seat for the fight. I do, because of Suzuki-san. The enemies come fast and furious, and I try to fend them off with my best moves.
Who's that guy who flashed on the screen for like two frames?
The flaws, the adrenaline, the battle royale. It's got something to do with a guy.
What's going on here?
I'm buying you beer. You've got to listen.
Man, he went on to like do Xbox and then EA.
That's when we learned about a little thing called
a... Is he still at EA in 2020? I think he is.
Try again. It all started for me in an arcade 9 years ago. So in 1993, the Virtua Fighter arcade version was completed. And 8 years later, last year, they finished Virtua Fighter 4, the arcade version. And they completed the PS2 version this March.
That's right. Again, with the one frame person on screen, why are they doing that?
Invented the 3D fighting game back in 1993. He's brought his latest game, Virtua Fighter 4, home on the PlayStation 2. Now, I know what you're thinking. We've all been here long enough to know. Virtua Fighter is made by Sega, right? How am I playing it on my PlayStation 2?
This is the launch of Virtua Fighter 4 on Sega for PlayStation 2. And for many of us here, that's still very difficult to say. However, this is, as official PlayStation Magazine described, the best fighting game ever made.
One thing dies,
wow.
Another is born. Games come and go, but the classics remain. That's how I found myself in San Francisco.
What was happening there? So this is right after Sega folded as a console developer, and official PlayStation Magazine is like being gracious about it.
That you can't get on the arcade game. The three main ones are the AI system, the training mode, and the character edit system. The first, training mode, allows users to learn as they play. And they have fun while they learn the moves and learn how to play the game.
It's got a training mode. That's cool.
Virtua Fighter 4 has over 400 hidden items in the game. These are like sunglasses, different clothes, different hats, all kinds of different things that you can use to customize your character and basically make a character all your own.
AI system.
Third is the AI system. A lot of people think that fighting games are only for hardcore gamers or the controls are too difficult and they can't really learn to play them. But even for people like that, they can use this AI system to train their own AI fighter and basically cheer them on and watch their character fight for the game.
What? I mean, I know games still do that today.
People from all over the world living one day.
But what a weird concept is something to promote.
There was a martial arts demonstration from the U.S. Wing Chun Kung Fu Academy. Which is fitting, because it was experiencing just such a kung fu demonstration that inspired Suzuki-san to create Virtua Fighter.
Who is this guy reading the script?
The original reason I decided I wanted to make Virtua Fighter.
Why did they think that was a good way to go with the video?
I saw a bunch of martial arts masters and really took an interest in that. And so when I came back to Japan and was describing this to my staff, I needed to be able to show them what sort of moves I was talking about.
I became addicted to his game in the arcades. Now I can play it at home. And I'm not alone. Four tournament winners from around the nation were brought to the Sega Fight Club to show us what they had and to fight for a Virtua Fighter 4 arcade machine signed by Suzuki.
Man, look at all these guys playing on pads.
Me out here on Saturday and gave me an amazing hotel to stay out and cash to go get in trouble with. And today I just won an arcade machine from Sega.
All night long we fought, shaking off our normalness, becoming more real. More alive. Now I'm not sure where the line is between the game and reality, where the fighting ends. The controller is in my hands, the PlayStation 2 is always on, and I think it's all because of you, Suzuki. I should know. I know the man and his games.
Man, I disapprove of the script. Of that video clip. But that seemed like just to be a little 5-minute video. So certainly there are worse things. Okay, yeah, I guess we'll do the Ultimate Fighter one next. Or Ultimate Fighting Championship, I suppose. Oh man, I forgot what UFC used to be like.
get when you combine boxers, wrestlers, and martial artists, put them in an octagon-shaped ring, and plant that ring in the middle of the craziest town on Earth? You get the Ultimate Fighting Championship. And when you take the Ultimate Fighting Championship to the PlayStation 2, you get a brand new fighting game, UFC Throwdown.
John Lewis. I don't remember a John Lewis.
UFC is Ultimate Fighting Championship. It's the premier mixed martial arts competition in the world. It was established in 1993 kind of as a spectacle for pay-per-view, pitting like...
So this would have been like 8 years after
martial arts out there.
UFC 1, which if there's 12 a year, there's like 96. So this is right around UFC 96. And as I record this, we just had UFC 234, 244.
Real contact.
John Jones beat Reyes in the final match of the night. So man, this time flies. Are they explaining what UFC is to people?
UFC 36 Worlds Collide at the MGM Grand Hotel.
It's mixed martial arts. It incorporates everything: boxing, kickboxing, Jeremy Horn. Submissions.
In the beginning of the sport, I think it was more or less people training with their own
Mikey
style.
Burnett.
Everybody's going out and trying to gather up people that know as much about each one of them as they possibly can.
I've trained in all of them, and for me, it's just something that combines them all and makes it more exciting. Like that.
An intelligible Chuck Liddell.
The best man leaves.
Man, when Chuck Liddell talks now, you gotta put subtitles up.
On the PlayStation 2. Not just because of the amazing action, but because of all the ways that you can play the game.
We have several modes in the game. The arcade is very similar to what you would want to play in arcade, where you just fight after fight after fight just to get into the action, play, have fun. The UFC mode is actually a simulation of the actual event, what you would see on a pay-per-view event on television. So you have bracketed systems where you move to win the championship belt.
Another mode is tournament mode. That's the party mode, where up to 8 players, human or computer-controlled players, can go into a game and battle it out in their own UFC tournament and vie for the ultimate control of their own octagon. And
they don't have any of those modes in the new UFC. They just have fight now and then career.
Career mode I played up as like the build the best mode, and what it does is it lets you spend anywhere from 10 or 15 hours really customizing your character.
In career mode, a player goes in and begins to create their character, chooses the fighting style, chooses how they look, skin tone, color their clothes, and decides to name them, their hometown, everything. And when they complete those, they get extra skill points that they can assign to things like their punch skill, grappling skill. If it's maybe a heavier fighter, he's going to start out slower, so they can increase their speed. After that is done, they can take them through a training process.
Well, you need to go see like a
UFC
master,
man. That was the name of his creative character.
The player through learning the different moves as opposed to just giving it to them. And you have a certain amount of like points,
which is something the UFC games today still do. So I mean, they borrowed a lot from the predecessors, I guess.
Boxing for striking, then I've got to go and actually meet with those masters, and they'll enter you into like small tournaments where you actually get more points.
UFC man.
Time to bring the action from the octagon to life.
Well, the beautiful thing about this game is our character models. We have character models that are 9,000 polys plus, which allows us to put a lot of detail into the characters. You'll be able to see their facial animations and the body. As you move your character's arms, the muscles will flex. You'll see hair from real textures that we created by actually taking photos of the fighters. So when you look at the fighters, you'll see scars, tattoos,
take pictures of them. Now they like do scans and they bring the scans in.
Extremely smooth.
But I mean, it was PS2, so it's pretty good for PS2.
Near perfection, because these are the fighters that we were trying to emulate and honor in this game. So they kind of need to be close into the detail. So hopefully the fighters will be happy and not come and make us their own little UFC.
With all the work that the UFC Throwdown team has done on the game, we wonder if they had any favorite characters.
Yeah, that's kind of a tough one because I've worked with these guys for about the last 2 years and I've met a lot of the fighters, and as I mentioned before, you know, a lot of them have become actually pretty close friends. These guys are totally different in the ring than they are outside of the ring. They're definitely some of the nicest guys you'll ever meet, and you'll never
could never understand that these
guys hit each other
as hard as they can in the octagon. I would have to probably say Chuck Liddell, the Iceman, because the guy's got just the most amazing kicks and punishing
good
kicks
old
that
chocolate
ever see in the UFC, and then we've replicated that really closely in the actual game.
The reason I use Tito Ortiz is because he's a well-rounded fighter. He has a lot of standing moves like punches, kicks, and a lot of ground moves, so he can work the ground as well. So if I'm fighting a wrestler, you know, he takes me down, I actually have really strong moves on the ground, and he's very diverse.
I'm hoping some of the fighters will come down and check out the game, and I'm hoping that they're gonna like it and have some fun with us.
But all we could get was the tap out guy. What was that move? Was that like an arm bar on the leg? A leg bar? But like, that was weird animation. All right, cool. Not bad. Not bad. Walk down memory lane. Man, do I not care about the making of Sony Computer Entertainment America.com, which of course would be Sony Interactive Entertainment of America.com. In the year 2020.
Here at the PlayStation Underground, we're dedicated to bringing you a one-of-a-kind, behind-the-scenes look at the hot new games coming out for the PlayStation 2. That's why we knew you'd want to find out how to get the jump on the hottest news. In summer 2002, Sony Computer Entertainment launches their new site created by San Francisco design firm 415. You're not going to believe what they have in store for you.
The way I would describe this site is almost as if it's a journey or a train that's taking you into this big, huge community of information and support for gamers.
So in that sense, it could be very much like a game. It's not a thumb-pressing, mad, kill-your-enemies game, but it hopefully is a great exploratory experience for all the people on it.
Well, there's tons
I wonder
of
if these people are still
the
making websites.
To get the best information, you have to be a member of the PlayStation Underground. But don't worry if you're not. It's free to join.
The biggest area of the site is the PlayStation Underground, and this is going to be really a community for gamers to go to get information on.
Why is she standing like up on a pedestal looking down, like over
cheats,
a banister?
Codes, hints, walkthroughs, cool moves for games that really don't exist on any other site. We'll also have the Game Finder, because with 1,500 titles, sometimes you don't know what game you might want to try next. Well, we'll ask the user different questions about what they might want in a game, and we'll provide them a list of games that might work for them.
So what does it take to build the premier gaming site on the web?
You might think that
so far that's the only
like
cool thing.
Start with us sitting around and brainstorming and figuring out all the great ideas that we can think of. But it turns out in reality, it's the gamers that come up with the ideas.
We actually talk to gamers and find out what they like or don't like about current things that are being done, where, you know, their kind of interests lie. So we really want to try to get into their head because they are the people that are going to be using the site.
By telling us about yourself, we can feed you information you want to get and also turn off information that you don't want to get. So I think the coolest part is letting them see we've gone beyond information to interaction.
And we also do a session with the client where we get everybody involved in the project together and everybody just throws out ideas.
It was fake business meeting.
And this is kind of developing some
with
kind these of
like pictures of the PlayStation 2 on the wall.
So we know exactly what they're talking about. And then we take this information that we get from our creative discovery, and then we take that back to our studio and start to work together with the other designers to come up with.
Oh, that was at Sony, I guess.
Directions that we may take.
I would say that the main difference between this project and a lot of the other projects we do is, simply put, the audience. They have extremely high standards for
well,
visuals.
Well, you could hire,
so we can really push the
what are they called, 415? Is that what they were called? Anyway, you could hire these guys to make websites for you, or you could just use,
That's a luxury.
Man, who are those people that sponsor YouTube videos all the time?
Audience.
Easy websites, templates.
Log on to the all-new www.sea.com to discover all the latest in PlayStation information, from peripherals and hardware to hints, cheats, and
I feel like you just go to PlayStation.com now. Sort by sales.
Check back because content is going to be constantly updated.
Summer 2002. In 2020, I am forgotten. All right, that wasn't that awful. right, the vault, I believe, is all we got left. Street Hoops, okay. UFC Throwdown, okay. Taz Wanted, hilarious. Freestyle, Freakstyle. Sledstorm, Stuntman, oh geez, Stuntman. Britney's Dance Beats, oh, we're gonna save that one for last. Matt Hoffman 2, Dragon's Lair 3D, what? And then Kingdom Hearts, we'll probably save Kingdom Hearts for last. Oh, but that's gotta be a video, right? Test Drive, man, there's so many. Okay, we'll start with Street Hoops, which is, okay, Street Hoops is a game. UFC is a game. Taz Wanted is a game. Freakstyle, game. Sledstorm, game. Are they all games? Oh boy, no videos. Britney's Dance Beats. Matt Hoffman. Okay, Matt Hoffman 2. Video. Oh, there's the man himself. So this is back when Tony Hawk Pro Skater was super popular. So they just started making like all of them. So Matt Hoffman got one. I forget that surfer, Kelly Slater, was that his name? Kelly Slater Surfing. They all just started getting their own kind of, you know, games. If this looks like fun to you, maybe you would also prefer Tony Hawk's Pro Skater. I know when we're chilling on the tour bus, which I guess Pro BMX 2, which was a different game. Oh no, maybe it was Matt Hoffman's Pro BMX 2. Maybe. I know when they're chilling on the tour bus, which I don't understand why they have a tour bus. I guess they used to tour? They would play the Matt Hoffman games. Maybe. On the bus. Man, what a trailer. Activision. It was Matt Hoffman's Pro BMX 2. There you go. Blood. Mild violence. I guess from crashing. All right. Dragon's Lair 3D is another video. Why? Who thought this was a good idea? Just re-release Dragon's Lair. Yeah, there it is. Dragon's Lair.
Dragon's Lair, a fantasy adventure where you become a valiant knight.
Oh, it was an actual 3D game.
From the clutches of an evil dragon. You control the actions of a
All right, I guess that's not a terrible idea. I guess just nobody wants it. It's not like anybody was like, man, I love Dragon's Lair. Wish they'd bring back Dragon's Lair. But I mean, I guess if you have the license, you might as well try and do something with it. And I guess I like the cell shading.
Lead on, adventurer. Your quest awaits.
But I do gotta say that Princess's outfit is problematic in the year 2020. Encore Software. They're probably not still around. All right, Kingdom Hearts, this has gotta be a video. Yeah. And this is for the first Kingdom Hearts? Because as I record this, it is for the first Kingdom Hearts. We are 1 year removed from the release of the third Kingdom Hearts and like 12 other games in between Kingdom Hearts 1 and 3. Man, I was so hyped for this game when it came out. But I think, spoilers, that'll be the next video up on YouTube. Bum, 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 bum. Such a good song. They share the same sky, one destiny. Except that wasn't really true. They were all different skies. And then in Kingdom Hearts 2, you go to Tron. Which was a computer world. It had no sky. Alright, we got the intro. I actually have a full playthrough of Kingdom Hearts 1.5 HD Remix on my YouTube channel. I really did like that game. I did some of the bonus content. I didn't do all of it because, again, I hate grinding. I don't have the patience to grind it out anymore. Man, what's that wand? He doesn't have that wand at the start, does he? Even if you pick magic, you don't have that wand. Maybe. I've never picked magic at the start. So this is when he meets them at the very start. Alright, still pretty early. Okay, the first world, Alice in Wonderland, I'm pretty sure. That's the jungle, there's Cloud in Colosseum Olympus. Oh, Winnie the Pooh, which was entirely optional. Yeah, there you go, okay, Tarzan. Little Mermaid, they're showing off all the worlds. Of course, Little Mermaid's the worst world of them all. Cool. Oh, Peter Pan. So good, man. What a fun game the first one was. Although I'm sure they're all fun. And of course, I say that as a current Square Enix employee. Please buy the Kingdom Hearts collection, which is like 10 games. They're all out there now. I think we just released it. Please buy 5 copies of it. Yuffie and Squall! Yeah! Isn't that the end of the game? There you go, Kingdom Hearts. Get hyped. For the next video, when I'll probably be playing... Where I'll probably be playing it. Man, look at all those... Where I'll probably be playing the demo version on the next demo disc. Alright, Test Drive is a video. Atari made like a racer?
Who's your mommy?
What? Oh man, they got the licensed tracks though. Oh man, they got a quote from the rival magazine, PlayStation Magazine. Not the official PlayStation Magazine. A story mode? Relentless cops. This was like competition for Need for Speed, I guess.
Can't touch this food.
You're going down, baby.
Later, dude.
Oh, the split screen. Ja Rule, DMX. Who? Junkie XL. Test Drive. There you go. I vaguely remember that cover. Obviously, the franchise didn't go anywhere. Oh man, like they're sticking on the screen for a while. I pressed the button to quick it out of that. Okay. Street Hoops, which was playable, right? It was. Okay. So, Okay, cool. So in order, Street Hoops. Let's play some Street Hoops. What? In your face moves. all right. I just want to move, pass, shoot, spin move, and crossover juke steal. All right. Pass and shoot. That's really all I need. I'm just going to mash the buttons. I definitely am not going to touch the shoulder buttons for Street Hoops. Black Ops Entertainment from Activision. Was that? What? Oh, okay. Here's some guys doing some street hoops. This is some Harlem Globetrotter shit. That's illegal. You can't roll the ball around like that. That's that can't be a good move unless in the street hoops rules. Yeah, this is just some Harlem Globetrotter stuff. There you go. No in-game footage for street hoops. And now we load. What's going on in the background there? All right, and this is some real life footage. Press start. What? Oh. Okay. Monster. Okay, the monster jammers or the ankle breakers? I'm definitely gonna go with the monster jammers, which is the away team. Headache. X-Man. AO. 50-50. Nasty novice. Normal novice. Yeah, I'm gonna go novice. Okay, the cage. 4th Street, New York. West 4th Street, New York. Today at 11 a.m. The street hoops are going down. Did I freeze on the loading screen? Okay, no. All right. Just because the basketball stopped moving. It's hard to remember what the PS2 rules were. But it definitely seems like I've frozen on the basketball screen or on the loading screen. Oh, okay. Just a long load. Oh, okay. What? Oh, did they score? Okay, they scored. Oh. Okay. Look at that sick dunk. Okay, big easy. Oh my god, no defense. Okay, they let me come back though because I'm playing on novice. I'm just gonna guard the hoop. No shot clock on the street hoops. Okay, there is. 10 seconds. An electronic shot clock on the street hoops. Shot clock violation, suckers. That's what you get for playing not. Let's go for. Oh man, they stole. Oh, he's got the break. But thankfully, he's a moron. Oh, steal back, but no. Okay, he's trying to. Big Easy, go for three. Ah, it didn't work, Big Easy. Pop. Oh, Big Easy, what a steal. You're going to go for three again, Big Easy. Oh, Big Easy. Yeah, bum me out, Big Easy, with your terrible shooting prowess. Oh, he dunked on me. Fierce. Motor City. Okay. Man of Steel is my top scorer. Oh, man. They're wrecking me. Oh, the rebound by Big Easy. To Man of Steel. Puts up the easy two. My first lead. Money shot, apparently. I don't know. Did I make some money there? Lady Griff. Out of bounds. These guys suck. What kind of pass was that? Oh, Big Easy's the worst. Is it because he's white? Man, my guys have no speed coming back. All right, Lady Griff. Lady Griff, deke this guy. Oh, deke this guy. Lady Griff. Bam. What? He tipped it in? BS. Alright, you redeem yourself, Big Easy. Alright, 14 seconds. Just gotta delay them for 14 seconds. Yeah, pass it around, chumps. 1-0. Suckers. We did it. And it was all thanks to Big Easy. Forget the pros. Play street basketball. Live street basketball. Bet on each game and earn cash to buy new clothes, tattoos, and hairstyles. Customized players, body type, jewelry, authentic clothing brands. And gameplay, one-on-one through five-on-five. Unique street basketball moves exclusive to Street Hoops. Play competitively and cooperatively. Street Hoops. Come on, Activision. I know you're making all kinds of money off of Warcraft and Call of Duty, but you gotta bring back the Street Hoops. Alright, let's do some UFC throwdown. Right kick, left kick, right punch, left punch. Seems easy. Four button controls. Fuck shoulder buttons. Man, if you played the new UFC games, pages and pages of the controller layouts. Alright, Crave Entertainment. Zuffa, they don't own them anymore. Opus.co.jp. Okay. Press the start button. Exhibition, UFC mode. Let's just do exhibition, I guess. One player versus Calm. Okay, who are my choices? Jens Pulver. I gotta stop doing this to my fans. Tito Ortiz, Chocolate Al, and BJ Penn. Okay. I guess I will be Chocolate Al, and I will fight Jens Pulver in a classic mismatch of weights. Militech fighting systems is Jens Pulver style. All right. There you go. I got 49 pounds on him and 7 inches.
Entertainment presents the finest mixed martial artists in the world, who will all
go Tito Ortiz. Man, look at the fans. Like, some of them, you can make it out who they are. Where's the Just Bleed guy? Man, they really changed. It's time. Go Tito Ortiz. I love Tito. I love Tito. They don't bring signs to MMA. Well, I guess they do, but not those kinds of signs. It's usually Brazilians. I like how it sounds like there's only 12 people in the crowd. Man, they love Tito, but Tito ain't fighting. I guess they were expecting you to pick Tito. Hey, Big John. John
McCarthy. All right, here we go, gentlemen. Are you ready? Are you ready? Let's get it on.
Let's get it on. What? Oh, suck it, Jens Pulver. Suck it, Jens Pulver. Oh, what? He beat me. No announcers. They couldn't get Joe Rogan. All right. Enough of that. I guess let's just see what UFC mode is. Okay, an open weight. We'll pick. Okay, we're put Tito versus Chuck Liddell. Yeah. All right. Here we go. Okay. Oh, that was knee to a down opponent almost. I'm gonna touch him with the jab. Touch him with the jab. You see the AI? Oh man. Oh man, he's got big power. Oh no, Chuck Liddell. Oh, he just let me stand up. Oh, who's gonna get KO'd first? Me! I KO'd him. You're done. Just button mashing. What was that celebration? Wow, they got like no damage. I wonder if there was damage in like the full game. I think there probably wasn't. All right, BJ Penn. Either BJ Penn beat Jens Pulver or either BJ Penn beat Jens Pulver or I have to fight everyone. Touch him with a jab. It's very arcadey. Oi! He KO'd me. Like, he just murdered me right there, but murdered. All right. Back to title. And I think you can... Yeah, quit game there. All right. Make sure to check out the full version. 28 fighters, 4 exclusive brawlers, whatever that means. Career mode, create a fighter options, which is career mode. And then I missed the last one. In-demand pay-per-view, watch UFC. There it is. You can't do that anymore. You have to sign up for ESPN. Oh, there was a loading screen for this. All right. Taz Wanted. Here we go. Eat, spin, jump, special attack. That's all that matters. Man, they've been making Taz games my whole life. I know he's a popular character, but... Infograms, maybe? Blitz games. Yeah, I guess, I don't know. I'm trying to think, like, what's the last Looney Tunes game I would have seen? It's hard to think. Choose my language.
Why you?
All right. Okay. Interesting use of the characters. Oh, okay. Need 2 controllers, which I don't have. So single player it is. Eliminate Taz Wanted posters. Rant costume attack, which I guess is special attack. All right, eat, spin, eat, spit, spin, jump. All right. Eliminate the Taz Wanted. Listen to Tweez advice. Find the posters. Collect the sandwiches. Destroy there everything you can. Look for Sam's henchmen. Watch out for acme traps. Answer the phone.
Queen up on aisle 4. There's a battery of ways to score if you step whitely. Get it? That was a clue. Sometimes you just have to take a dive to reach the top.
All right, then. Oh, I've got 15 minutes. Oh, okay, I'm wearing my NBA Jam.
Have your hide, varmint.
Okay. All right. Okay, so right stick is the same thing, where if I turn the stick to the right, it goes left, and if I go left, it goes right, and if I go up, down. Why do they always reverse it? Okay, so those guys... Okay, can't sneak past them, unless... Unless I sneak past them. Nope. Okay, the dog gets me also. Can I get this guy? Nope. Oh, I'm sick from too much spinning, maybe? Whoa. another guy. He's trying to catch me. Okay, don't jump in the water. Okay, I ate some dynamite that made me sick. I feel like I want to jump here. Nope. What is happening? Oh. I think I have to go downstairs maybe? Blocked off. Well, I like how the music kicks in when I do my my spin. Okay, I made him dance. Oh, there's totally a poster in here. Come on, how do I get inside? I've destroyed 25% of things. How do I get inside? I'm not quite sure how to get inside that store. And it's been 5 minutes of a whole lot of nothing. So, none of that makes any sense. Hint. You'll need to charge the batteries before you go for a workout. Yeah, I don't, go, and the batteries is down there. I don't understand this map. Options. You have to do the whole 10 minutes, 15 minutes? Really? Okay, so you do that, and now I have a timer. The timer for what? A timer for this? Okay, can't spin on the water. A little confused and don't want to sit around for another 7.5 minutes, so we're gonna do this reset game. All right, well, that's Taz for you, I guess. I mean, it's a thing, not particularly interesting in my opinion. Yeah,
welcome to issue 59.
I don't know what the target audience was for that. It might have been a little bit younger than 38 years old.
And find out what goes
into okay. Oh, no. Okay, controller. Okay, skip that. Skip. Oh, I can't skip. Okay, can't skip. Gotta see the credits. All right. The vault. Man, so many games. Okay. Freak Style. Break, accelerate, tricks. Boost and tweak. Accelerate, break. Whoa, okay. Yeah, definitely not going to use the stick for that. Start. All right. Freak Style. Also trying to capitalize on the popularity of, I don't know, the X Games or Tony Hawk or what the fuck was that guy? Oh, man. So after the Matt Hoffman one, what did they do? They did that like pornographic one on Xbox, I think. BM Triple X or something, whatever it was called. Where you just had like topless girls. Single race.
Metz is my name, and
Mike
my
Metzger.
Game.
Brian
I'm
Deegan.
Deegan. And I'm the leader of the metal militia.
Hi there.
Leanne. Which I guess I can't pick. Yeah. Steffi Bao.
I am Steffi and I love to ride.
Clifford Adaplane. Adaptante, maybe? Mike Jones? Jessica Patterson.
If you're looking for
Greg Albertson. How many people? Okay, just Greg. Let's get Greg his entrance. South African? Doesn't exist. Okay. Mike Metzger. All these bikes I can't. Let's go. I feel like I can't do these tracks. Okay, there you go. Accelerate, no brakes. Just accelerate, boost, tweak, and tricks. Breakins for chumps. In the freak style. Oh, EA Big. This was after SSX. They just wanted to do more. All right. Yeah. Player one, tagged. First one to the finish line takes it all. Okay. Let's hope I do better than I did in my SSX 2 one. Oh no, what are these controls? Nope. Last place. Okay. Little skiddy. What? Okay, don't drive on the walls.
Knock, knock.
Oh, he's dead. Okay. Okay, the break is, it's a strong break. No, I can't, buddy. Oh, I keep doing the same tricks. Somehow I'm still in last, even though I feel like I just passed three people. Okay, 4-6. Why did I get such a bonus right there? Oh, I hit the thing. What is happening? Have we done a full lap? Are there crates you can pick up like a carter? Like a kart racer? There's the lap. How many laps are there? And I'm in first. Oh boy, that's no good. Or is it? I just want to go through the shortcut. Oh, okay. No, I don't. Yes, I do. Alright, so it's very arcadey controls.
No footer. Seat grab. That's a trick zone.
So what if I'm last? Look at my fat trick score. It up. I'm gonna hit that thing again. Oh, there was definitely a shortcut right there. Okay, I was unsure, but I finished second.
Whatever.
Cool. Yeah, second place ain't that bad. Over 100 sick tricks, hundreds of special combos, 9 wicked whirl, and then it corrupted. Corrupted image. Okay. Cool. What we got? Oh man, 3 more to go. Okay, Sledstorm, which can't be that different from what I just played, except on ice instead of dirt.
EA Sports.
EA Big. They were like, fuck it. Just keep pumping them out. Keep pumping them out. Tracy, all right, cool. Oh, Simon's back. Zoe Payne, she was also in SSX at one point, I think. Sam. Oh, Elise. Cool. I saw Elise. Unless she's just wearing the same jacket as Elise. Play game. Single player. Quick race. Tracy, TJ, Zoe, Sam Griffin, Nicholas Erickson, Gavin Meyer, Simon, Alex, Tracy. Who I think is the only person I can play. Okay, and I feel like, yeah, just one thing. Cool. Just one track. Let's go. All right. EA big, given the demos, given the same games over and over again. Why not? I'm sure they made money. Or maybe they didn't. That's why they stopped making them. This deadly bird. Man, what a time to be alive when, like, one game was so popular they made 15 copies.
Welcome to the mysterious world of Bermuda Bird!
The ice caverns, while beautiful, are a treacherous part of the course.
Speaking of beautiful and treacherous, let me tell you about my date with Alex last night.
She's sure to run an aggressive race here.
Oh, I like him aggressive, Big Kirk dog.
This one's for Amelia Earhart.
Phoebe is for pussies, man! Go!
What a poor... Amelia Earhart? Did he just call me a pussy? Okay, I fucked up the start for sure. Okay. It's a little less arcadey here. Oh. Than the BMX one was, or the dirt bike one was. Simon. I got points for smashing that. Okay. I have no idea if I have boost or not. Like, anyway. Okay, I missed that trick opportunity. At least I was in first for a second. Oh man, so they're all drifting. Look at them, Tokyo drifting around the corners. What? Dead. Oh, you have to like jump start the sled. Hilarious. I feel like they're rubber banding me here. Giving me a chance to catch up. Man, what, like, did they put like the C team on this game? I feel like it's like half the game that Tricky is. Graphics wise, character model wise, UI wise. Nope, shouldn't have gone for the trick. First place to last, because I went for the trick. Why does this happen? Because I don't know the course. Shortcut over there. Last place! What a loser. Okay. Well, they're high impact, neck and neck arcade racing action, 40 unique sleds, extreme characters, crazy tricks, 7 unique tracks, more bullet points. All right, and it just quit me out of the game. They were like, you're done. All right, Stuntman, another difficult-to-play game. Accelerate, brake, handbrake. Cool. Whew. The intensity of the demos on this disc really working me over. Infograms from Atari bringing me Stuntman. And I feel like they made 2 Stuntmans and then Atari went out of business. Reflections Interactive, not out of business, but you know, sold off a lot of their stuff. Rolling demo, playable, what? Well, definitely the playable demo. If one of them is just a video, I don't want to watch that. All right, action button. Anyway, accelerate, brake, handbrake.
This is an adventure story. I play the hero, Dakota Scott. He has to find the ancient scarab before the bad guy.
Oh, I don't care about any of that plot. Yeah, so then I just have to do the things that they tell me to do here. A jump. Be within score zone during explosion. Squeeze through a gap. Press the action button. Okay, cool. Another one of these loading screens that isn't telling me I'm loading. All right. Scarab, if Indiana Jones had... Oh, no. Action. No, please. Oh, man. Okay, I guess I'm in first person.
Hit the barrier. Left of the truck.
Oh, that 180 didn't make
hard
any
left.
Sense.
Hit truck. Too slow.
Yeah, and this is like Stuntman. I remember renting this thing and like not being able to like beat the fucking tutorial. The controls are not good. Forcing me to be in the driver's seat is even worse. Please wait. Man, look at that long load. Ooh, boy.
Take 2. Action.
I wonder if they go to, like, take 1,000.
Hit the barrier.
How high do they count?
Left of the truck. Hard left. Hit truck. Smash through stall.
See, I didn't hit...
Mark stalls. 180 e-brake. Left of explosion.
Oh man, I thought that was a jump.
Cut. That was too slow.
Left of explosion. I thought they wanted me to jump. All right. Well, you get it. That's Stuntman. No point in seeing me fumble through that 50,000 times. Let's get to the good stuff, which is Britney's dance beat. That's what we all want. Yeah, quit the demo. Here we go. Dance, dance. Dance, dance. Sounds easy. So this is like Parappa Rappa style. You know, kick punch, you all remember? Or Jamalami. Which were games I can't beat. For whatever reason, I have a hard time pressing those buttons in sync. THQ! Man. Sweet dreams, THQ. Britney Brands, NVU, Metro. Who are all these people? THQ presents Brit Britney Spears. And the late 90s, early 2000s was, what a time. Britney, of course, been through some shit since then. Remember that Pepsi Super Bowl commercial where Bob Dole got an erection? Forget how much of like a sex object they used her as. What's in the video vault? Behind the scenes, immersive video. Yeah, okay. Let's start with the audition. I guess I'll be Elisa. New game. Yeah. Maybe one more time. First audition. Oh, I'm facing Rob. Okay, here we go. Man, I've definitely played a different Britney game. Oh, the full song is in the background. Just pressing things as you're over them. Oh, he gets a little, man, he's kicking my ass.
You can do better.
My turn? Was that Britney?
Come on now. You can do it.
Oh no, I'm losing it hard. Hit me, baby, one more time. It's kind of in beat to the music.
Now you're getting it.
Man, did he try and hit me with like a fucking combo breaker there with the triangle? Oh, I'm Britney.
That was awesome. You can do it. Looks like we need to work on this.
Oh man, I'm starting to like get a little cramp in my forearm. I'm so into it. I'm holding the controller so tight. Oh no, he's look at him. How come I don't get like a comp? Did I have it? I don't see what he's doing.
That was hot. Now you're getting it.
Man, Rob, fuck you. Fuck you, Rob. You're taking my champ, my big break, Rob.
Keep dancing. Hang in there. Come on now. My loneliness is killing me. I must confess, I still believe. You can do it.
Oh, you fucked me, Rob.
Don't stop.
There she is. She's Britney. Guide me, Britney, to victory.
Keep dancing.
Oh, I'm losing so bad.
Come on now.
Hit me, baby, one more time. Oh, he kicked my ass. I feel like I was winning for a while there, but he destroyed me at the end. Oh, she died while he breakdances. And she cries. It's over. Time to become a stripper, Elisa. It's the only thing you're good at is dancing. But not as good as Rob. Yep. There you go. See if you have what it takes to dance like Britney in Britney's Dance Beat features. And of course, there's full-on dance games now where you have to do full-on dancing and not just hit buttons to the beat. So, man, oh man, time has changed. And I guess I'm just going to be stuck on the screen until I press a button. But that's okay, because that's the mild lyrics. What? Is that like because she has like all these sexy songs? Anyway. Nope. Okay. Kick me out after what seemed like 20 seconds, but that's going to be the end of it because we've done the entire demo disc. So, what a fun time that was. 2001 was a interesting time for video games. I'd like to thank everybody for watching.